What's good, dudes? You know what it is. You know what it is. It's your boy, got back with another reaction video. Before we get into this, you know what to do. Turn me up, lock up with us on Kick and Twitch. You know how to do it. Let's do them both. We're about to react to this situation with Plaque Boy Max, man. Basically, what's going on here? Gas Baby said Plaque Boy Max exposed his laser den for having an ego.
That's his big. Is that not his biggest song, bitch? That's his biggest fucking song. This song war shit was really something that Five really months. Helped niggas. It helped niggas. It pushed niggas forward. How you gonna try to? And pay a nigga to do it, dog. Bro, I put my heart and soul into this shit. And it's like niggas just blatantly disrespect me, bro. The fuck? Bro, I hate that.
Supposedly, Laser and his team paid Kaisa not to do an E-Day and Diss Wars. Max is mad that they ain't do it with him because he gave Laser his biggest song and he tried to hit him up when he was in Miami, but Laser never hit him back for the IRL stream. RIP Song Wars, Max clearly cared about the community. Facts. Apparently, he not doing no more UG Song Wars. Shit was mad entertaining too. It's his team, not Lil Laser. His team been tweaking in the past few weeks. We haven't been in contact from anyone. Wait, we haven't been in contact from anyone from Max's team and no one notified us of nothing. Whoa, who's this? Hold this L. Whoa, W Max, I'm dead. Max be carrying the underground. Hey, look, man. This is something that happens in the underground, bro. I feel like for a while, streamers didn't understand how much power that they really held in this shit. And rappers kind of just, you know, pick and choose and, you know, who to take advantage of in this. And it's unfortunate to see what they're doing to Max. Because it's true, bro. Laser Den really did, honestly. He really was a viral sensation, getting thousands of comments after the song wars with Plaque Boy Max and the E-dates and shit like that. And yeah, I am gonna bring that up. I am gonna bring that up. Not the cat's out of the bag. It's not even like Laser Den and them egoed us. And I'm not even gonna lie, no, because I remember I did tell a couple people in the Discord and shit like that, like, yo, we might get in tune with Laser Den, we might get a Laser Den show. I had a sponsor that reached out to me and they wanna get me to do a show with an underground artist. There was a specific budget involved. I reached out to Laser Den's team. And yo, I'm not gonna lie, they hit me back. They said that they were gonna do it. They were down to do it and everything. And the reason why my sponsor backed out of it and we're not gonna do it is because somebody else got their hands on Laser and he's gonna be in New York soon. I'm gonna be at that event anyway. You know what I'm saying? But I just think that after the song wars, after the diss wars or song wars or whatever occurred between Plaque Boy Max and all the other streamers on that situation, Laser Den went up and took advantage of his situation. People got to understand, Laser Den is a kid from the hood. He's poor, and he raps about being poor. He lets it be known, and he's looking for opportunities to grow. If he already was on Plaque Boy Max's platform and benefited off of it, I think, you know, he's going to now try to prosper off Kai Cenat's platform and benefit off that. You know, and after he got on Kai Cenat's platform, might even try to get on Aiden's platform. You know, they're maybe just trying to continuously elevate from one thing to another, you know, because we all know what happens in the underground too. You do a song wars or whatever, you do one thing, all right, it's good, you do it again, it's all right, you start to do it more, people start to deem it as corny, things start to die out, people start to say things are dried out, and you know, you kind of just don't want to risk that, especially when you're Laser Den and you got a lot of things going on for you right now. But yeah, the egoing is kind of crazy. Not answering Max for the IRL stream. You at least could have pulled up and did that, you know, solidified the relationship. You know what I'm saying? Because that's usually how that shit go. You know what I mean? Usually a rapper, a rapper is either going to associate with a streamer and then they're going to lock in person, or the streamer is going to associate with a rapper and then they lock in person, because sometimes the streamer is bigger than the rapper, sometimes the rapper is bigger than the streamer. So at this point, Plaque Boy Max is the streamer that was bigger than Laser Den. So it would have been good for that full circle moment, and for Plaque Boy Max to not get that, it's kind of whack. It's kind of whack. Kai Cenat responds. Oh, no. It's crazy how accessible Laser was when he first got noticed. Now he become a little rare. That's true. I ain't gonna lie. I was the first streamer to react to LaserDim, so, and I ain't never got a DM, an answer. I ain't gonna front though. I did tweet at LaserDim one time, and I was like, yo, let's do the interview. And he said, ready when you are. But I want to do interviews in person. And I kind of didn't want to do the Discord interview. And then the Playboy Max thing happened, and things got way bigger than me. You know what I'm saying? I'm not going to be upset about that, though. I'm not going to throw no, you know, tantrums or anything. I'm just going to respect the fact that I'm just not a big enough streamer and things got out of my hands. You know what I'm saying? I feel like as streamers, sometimes we do got to respect that. If LaserDim is now in contact with Kai Cenat, I think Playboy Max, you know, like, it is fucked up that Laser ain't do that full circle moment with Plaque, but it's definitely because, you know, Laser is now trying to go to the next bigger streamer above Max. And it just is what it is, you know? It is what it is.
Twin, I don't know what to tell you, Twin. What the fuck going on, Twin? Little Twin, you come to the spot, Little Twin. Like, I don't know, Little Twin. I don't even know what to tell you, Little Twin. I'm surprised, Little Twin. I fuck with you, Little Twin. I ain't gonna count to you, Little Twin.
Hey!
Hey, no, hey. Appreciate you. What's that I say? Hold on. Appreciate you, little twin. Little twin, I ain't gonna lie. Appreciate you, little twin. Appreciate that, little twin. Thank you so much, little twin. You can't do your thing, little twin, online. Appreciate you, little twin. Let me know we need something, little twin. Let me talk to you, little twin.
Okay, Kai kept it professional. Kai kept it professional. They're calling Kai the underground colonizer. And I think people just got to understand, bro. Kai built the platform. You know what I mean? He built the platform for himself. And you gotta pay to play in this shit, because that's what he do. You know what I mean? I just saw the recent transactions that just happened between him and the sex worker, the OnlyFans girl. And you know what I noticed was Kai's paying people. When you see a flyer, he's paying somebody good money for that flyer. He's paying the people around that he's going to good money for what he do. So when you come to Kai, you gotta come and you gotta pay to play. You know what I mean? And it's like, when I see the Playboy Max situation, Playboy Max did put money in LaserDim's pocket when LaserDim needed it. You know, but it's also, I feel like Playboy Max also saw the opportunity with LaserDim. It's like, you know what, I'm gonna take care of him. It's the righteous thing to do. It's also an opportunity, you know what I mean, to put somebody on. Somebody that, I feel like Playboy Max is smart enough to know that, like, after he do what he do with LaserDim, it's gonna work. You know what I'm saying? It's gonna work. And it worked so well that it caught the eyes of people like Kai Cenat. And it's not Kai Cenat's fault, you know. It's just once people step into that audience, once Kai Cenat audience get a hold of you, you're just in a different conversation. And I feel like LaserDim probably felt that. He definitely felt the difference from when Playboy Max got involved, and you can only imagine what he felt after Kai Cenat got involved as well. It's That's how this shit go, man. This is why you gotta tap in as soon as you can. But for all the other rappers, man, I think it's a good opportunity for anybody that Playboy Max reaches out to for a Song Wars. You know what I'm saying? Because you've seen what happened with LaserDim, and if you want to be that guy as well, I think, you know, it's a good opportunity. You know what I mean? Because it definitely put LaserDim at the top of the underground, bro. Every LaserDim reaction that I do does numbers. Every LaserDim music video that I see has numbers under it. Let's see, last time I looked at his following, when I was talking to the sponsor maybe a month ago, he had about 160,000 followers, I think. 140, I think. 150, I'll say. Let's see, LaserDim. Where's he at now? Damn, why is my Wi-Fi on? What the fuck? Okay, whatever. He's at 272,000 followers now. He did 100,000 followers since the last time I looked at his Instagram. You know what I'm saying? LeBron James' children is locked in with LaserDim. It's like, it's a whole different bracket at this point. You know what I'm saying? So, this is a big reason why streamers are selected with who they associate with, who they speak about, who they bring attention to, because this is what happens, bro. People turn around and forget what you did for them to an extent, to an extent. Pretty sure Laser is gonna turn around and, you know, pay his dues and do what he gotta do, and, you know, pull up to Blackboy Max and do the stream and make things right. I would hope he does the righteous thing, you know what I'm saying? Especially after all this is on the internet. He definitely sees it, you know? But, yeah. I'm fortunate to see the way rappers move. I think it's time for you guys to, you know, come across the bridge and lock in with the streamers officially. I feel like every rapper should have their streamer. You know, like every rapper has their producer, you know, their videographer. I think it's time for every rapper to have their streamer as well. Tap in with the streamer that you can get in, that you can get in tune with. You know what I mean? A streamer that you can have that genuine relationship with. You feel me? And rock out until you could pick up and lock into the next thing. You know what I mean? Because I feel like, I know for sure and for certain that us streamers are definitely a big part of the growth of these rappers, especially these days. A lot of these rappers aren't taken serious until a lot of us streamers start talking about them and reacting to them and posting videos about them. So yeah, like, you're not popping if nobody reacts to your music. It's just a definite fact. You're not lit. You don't have motion if niggas are not reacting to you. Or at least somebody, or people are not at least in reactor stream, like, yo, it's time to start talking about this guy. You know what I mean? And that's just what it is now. So yeah, y'all know what it is. Y'all let me know what you guys think about this Blackboy Max situation. Is Laser Dim wrong for this? Is Blackboy Max overreacting? Is Kai Cenat the colonizer? Let me know. It's your boy, A-Guy, back with another reacts video. If you get out of here, turn me up. Like with us on Kick and Twitch. You know how to do with us. You are in both. Peace.